Hello, it's May 30th, 2018, and today I went and saw a surgical oncologist down here in Richmond, and one of the options he mentioned was a procedure that would attack the cancer on my liver, the various four or five different areas where they detect what they highly suspect is cancer, and pretty much in their mind confirmed it's cancer, by going through veins that lead to ultimately these areas that would radiate these areas, not in a traditional way of using radiation, but by using microscopic little radiation bombs, as it was kind of described, that would hopefully go and eradicate and destroy the cancer on site. They would not use, again, traditional radiation, which would cause more damage than any possible good. The surgeon, seemed pretty confident about it and almost enthusiastic about the idea. But he'll have to meet with a panel of other doctors next week, maybe 12 doctors, and get other people's opinions on the procedure. Get in contact with me and let me know what the plan is. I feel optimistic. I mean, it gives me hope, you know. I don't know if this would be with or without chemo. I don't know the duration. I think it's a one-time thing, I think. I'm not sure. Now, the doctor says that, you know, an atypical case in my cancer is not behaving the way normal, you know, pancreatic cancer normally behaves. And so a lot of what's happening with me is exploratory and maybe even experimental. But anything that might help, I'm open to, and that makes sense to me. And I'd be elated if it meant no chemo. But I don't know how my doctor, oncologist, is going to receive this, because he says that the cancer's in my blood. So I'm thinking that if it is approved and agreed upon, it may not be unanimous, and it may involve chemo as well. So that's where I stand in terms of that. Otherwise, I feel great, feel good. I'm eating a lot because I know I won't be able to eat a lot after, you know, the chemo starts. You know, that whole thing where with the nausea and the loss of appetite will be revisited. So I'm trying to eat and enjoy everything now. I'm also, I had planned on taking a trip, either Las Vegas or the Dominican Republic or Costa Rica. I had narrowed it down to Las Vegas, but it's been kind of ruled out now for logistical reasons. But I was going to take it as early as this Sunday. You know. I have to put it off for a few weeks. And maybe try to go to Costa Rica. I just want to sit on a beautiful beach and talk to God on the sand and look at the beautiful waters and get away just for a few days and enjoy that sort of thing. Not that it's my last hurrah, something I've always wanted to do, and it could very well be my last hurrah. So I have to be realistic about it. Or open to all the possibilities, but hopefully not. But I will schedule something else, you know, far later. sucking out something to look forward to. My mood's been okay. I mean, I'm not doing much. There's not much I can do right now. Wrote letters to disability, had doctors write letters, and hopefully get that money coming in, because I'm almost completely on money, and this world runs on money, you know. My world socially has been interesting, you know. I'm cool where I am, right? You know, I don't really seek a lot from people, but it's kind of interesting. I'm not hearing from people, siblings and people I thought were close friends, some people haven't even returned text or calls, and I really can't understand that, but it is, as it said, what it is, and I can't dwell on that. I don't want to expend my energy that way. So for those who do express their concern and love, I appreciate it. I'm going to fight my fight. I'm going to do my thing. I might be here for another, matter of months, so I could be here for, several years or even a few more, decades. I'm leaning toward the latter. I want to be here to see my son to adulthood, and we've heard that, and it's repetitious at this point. And my wife has experienced a lot of loss. I don't want her to experience any more loss, or my family, those who really, will be affected, close to me. But overall, I feel, pretty well. I've been watching a lot of TV and exercising some, playing my music, and I want to get back to writing. Hopefully, I will get this money coming in through disability, and that horrible fight can come to a positive end. So that's where things are. Just wanted to take some time to update and share what's going on in my world. And as usual, for those who you may know who may be suffering from something, give them love and just treasure every moment and live your life, do positive things, and you never know how, whom these things are affecting, how these things you do are being received by others, do those beautiful things, I'm gonna say goodnight now, and I hope the Cleveland Cavaliers can pull it off against the Golden State Warriors. I don't think they'll be able to. Say Golden State in the six, they have far too much firepower, and I'm not particularly a fan of LeBron James, but I did live in Cleveland for 6-7 years, and I've got nothing in particular against them, like some people seem to. I enjoyed the previous series, I'll tune into this one and see if they can pull it off. So in the meantime, I hope to see Serena, come back from having a baby and maybe win this French Open as well. And more importantly, hope that justice and goodness will find, more room for itself and make more room for itself in what is, an ailing state in America and in the world. And goodness will prevail. I watched a lot of things, and kids being mistreated and human trafficking. It's just hard to fathom how people can do these horrible things, and hopefully you know, justice will prevail, goodness will prevail, and compassion, you know, will play the bigger part in people's hearts than just financial greed and self-gratification. So once again, I will, you know, thank you for your, you know, kindness and your concern, and I feel good. And chemo is supposed to start, you know, on the 11th of June, and but maybe we'll get good news and not need it, or have something else to go along with it that might help bring this thing to a eliminate the cancer, essentially. So, peace and blessings.